Before I invite Reverend Father Lijo Daniel for the session, may I acknowledge the presence of two special friends. One is Esther Gordon from the Ethiopian Orthodox Church and Martha Joseph Massey of the Coptic Orthodox Church from London. Welcome to our family and thank you so much for your presence over here. We have with us Reverend Father Lijo Daniel. He is the assistant vicar of the Khadki Church in Pune. And he's the joint vice president of the Pune region of the MGOCSM. Achin?
Hello.
Yes, Achin.
Achin, can you hear me?
Yes, Achin.
Okay. Thank you, Achin. Glory be to the triune God. Respected clergies, senior friends of MGOCSM, all the students from both the diocese, Mumbai and Ahmedabad, and all those who are attending this meeting from abroad and India. Greetings to you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. First of all, I would like to appreciate the work of Jacob and Ishachan along with the Bombay MGOCSM office bearers to conduct a prayer meeting through the social media which are available for us. If this lockdown wouldn't have been there, we couldn't have this prayer meeting. In other words, if I say, if this meeting couldn't happen in our life, we couldn't know about the importance of Holy Spirit, which was rather like a dove, like a pigeon, like a fire, like a water. It would have been an understanding like that in our life. So, I would like to appreciate them for taking so much pain to arrange all this thing. May God bless you all. As we are coming to the end of the lockdown, nationwide lockdown on May 31st. Hope so. I don't know about the future, but nationwide lockdown will be ending on May 31st. Nearly 60 days of lockdown in our life journey, which we never expected or never saw or never heard in last 100 years. But Holy Bible gives us many images of lockdown, particularly on community basis and individual based lockdowns in the Holy Scripture. So I would like to, first of all, share some images of lockdown in the Holy Bible, especially in the Old Testament. When we go through Old Testament, the first book of the Bible, we can see the first image of the lockdown in Genesis chapter 6 to chapter 9, where the whole earth was filled with water and whole creation in pairs, the whole creation in pairs were saved in the Noah's Ark. Secondly, in the book of Genesis itself, we can see a 7 year of lockdown in the time of our patriarch Joseph. The Egypt was full of famine for 7 years, and God guided Joseph to take care of the Egypt and Egyptian people. And many more we can see if we come to the prophet books, 40 days and 40 nights of lockdown for the Nineveh people, for the wrongdoing which they have done. Along with that, there are many images we can see about lockdown in the Old Testament. As we move to the New Testament, our baby Jesus Christ also went down to lockdown to Egypt when the King Herod the Great wanted to kill Jesus Christ. After that, we can see the disciple, when Jesus was crucified, went for 3 days of lockdown due to the fear of Jewish leaders. Again, they went for 10 days of lockdown, which we are observing as a awaiting day in Jerusalem. So totally, lockdown is not a new term for humankind. It is a reminder to human beings that God is the ultimate power in this universe, which we have forgotten in some or other ways. Likewise, We are all locked down in our big concrete walls of our house. That is the home sweet home, which we say. It is not due to the fear of corona, but due to the fear of existence in the period to come, in the years to come, in our life journey. My beloved friends, the fear of our existence has created many psychological disturbance in our life, especially in our mind, soul and body. Though we are enjoying at a home sweet home with our parents, with our family members, posting photos on Instagram and Facebook of variety of coffees, variety of images, variety of dishes which we are preparing, but day to day we are getting physically, we are happy, but psychologically we are disturbed due to the news channel which we saw all day along. Due to the news channel, we are getting to know that how many people are dying. So it's a big fear that our extinction or the existence which we are facing will be questioned in our coming years. So when it comes to our spiritual being, as we are fear about our existence, there comes the work of Holy Spirit in our life. The work of Holy Spirit to inspire us spiritually, to bear good fruit for us, our family, and our church and our nation too. So the topic given to me or assigned today is the Holy Spirit inspires us. We all give reference, we all give preference to a personal, professional and social inspiration in some or other ways, but our spiritual inspiration is totally zero. Now the lockdown has played an important role in building up our spiritual inspiration through this Zoom prayer meeting, which couldn't have been possible if the lockdown was not there. Because busy in work, family, traveling, etc., these days and this fellowship wouldn't have come in our life journey. Awaiting days is the most important days of the church, where church itself goes to lockdown in prayer, fasting and vigil and repenting for the grace and gift of the Holy Spirit. So I'm getting into my topic, that is inspiration by the Holy Spirit to inspire our spiritual being to go, grow and nourish spiritually to bear good fruits in our life journey. First of all, we need to know the meaning of word inspire. So the word inspire in English dictionary gives a meaning to create something, or the better meaning, inflame, to get inflamed. Inflame is the proper word in regards to Holy Spirit. Spiritual inspiration is the flame of fire by the Holy Spirit, which enlightens our spirit to the real light, that is Jesus Christ. So the meaning is very clear to all of us. As we are talking about spiritual inspiration related to Holy Spirit, let us know what all things are inspired around us. As we heard a small description by Cheryl Jacob about the inspiration of Holy Spirit, I would like to share that who all are inspired by Holy Spirit around us. Genesis chapter 8, 11 and 12. There we can see a dove. A dove sent by Noah outside the ark to see what's the condition outside. And the dove went and bring an olive leaf. And it was a race of hope. Thirdly, when he sent the dove again, the dove didn't come back to him. That is the work, the inspiration work of Holy Spirit. Along with that, forefathers like Abraham, Jacob, Isaac, Joseph, and all the patriarchal fathers, along with judges, kings, prophets in the Old Testament, disciples in the New Testament, are inspired by Holy Spirit. Along with that, Holy Spirit, Holy Scripture, which is the Word of God, written by the disciples and gospel writers, is inspired by Holy Spirit, which we can see in 2 Timothy chapter 3:16. The first church formed on the day of Pentecost was inspired by the work of Holy Spirit. At last, Genesis chapter 1 verses 2, the verse which we all know. The wind or the Spirit of God swept over the face of the water. That means the whole creation is inspired by Holy Spirit. The living and the non-living things are inspired by the Holy Spirit. You all know Mor Aphraim. Mor Aphraim, in Malayalam, if we say Mor Aphraim, the Syriac father, Syriac church father, in his memora, in his song about the Holy Trinity, says about the Holy Trinity in this way: all the creation was made by Father. All the creation was made by Father, redeemed by the only begotten Son, and perfected and inspired till now by the Holy Spirit. All the creation was made by the Father, redeemed by the only begotten Son, and perfected, inspired till now by the Holy Spirit. That means the meaning is clear. You, I, and the whole creation is perfected and inspired by the Holy Spirit. So the spiritual inspiration which we all lack in our life journey, because we give preference to physical inspiration rather than spiritual inspiration, human beings have been zero in their spiritual life journey. So now in this evening, I would like to share three important factors. There are many factors, but three important factors that hinder the spiritual inspiration, the work of the spiritual inspiration in us by the Spirit. The first foremost hindrance is priority to the world and worldly things. Priority to the world and worldly things. St. John 17:15. That is the very famous highly priestly prayer by Jesus Christ, where he says, doesn't take them out of the world, but protect them from the evil one. When we see priority to the world, you all might be having a question that if we are living in this world, we should be with this world. I didn't say that you should not give priority, but when we give too much of priority, our spiritual life is becoming dark and dark day by day. So when we live in this world, worldly things are part and parcel of our life, but always the priority should be God. Ask yourself about your priority, especially when we are going through the awaiting days, the days when the early church meditated, contemplated, reflected about what is their stand in future. So this day should be a contemplating day, thinking about our future, that what is our priority. If God is the priority, then the Holy Spirit will inspire us in our life journey. If not, world or the evil is our priority, when it will drive us into darkness. Second priority or second hindrance that hinders the spiritual inspiration in our life journey is sufferings in the world. We all know sufferings in the world. Suffering is a part and parcel of this world. But sufferings are of many types, which we face in different phases of our life. Suffering caused due to others, like corona, which we are facing, it is due to others. Suffering caused by us, that means I am addressing to a youth member or youth forum. Suffering to the youth forum means addiction, other problems in our life, and suffering due to the nature. And many more sufferings are there. So these are the types of suffering which we face in different phases of our life. All these sufferings will come in our life. If we are not able to overcome it, it will take us into darkness. Almost in our life journey, we always fail to cover, always fail to overcome this suffering because we don't have that spiritual inspiration in us. But St. Paul says in a different way to the letters to Hebrew, that is chapter 2 verses 18. Chapter 2 verses 18. He mentions about the suffering of Christ. Christ is able to help us in our suffering because he has suffered and overcome. So suffering in our life shouldn't hinder our spiritual inspiration because we are believing in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ who have suffered more than you and me in this world. So we are taking the support and the help of Jesus Christ to overcome our suffering. So if we can overcome our suffering, the Holy Spirit in us will help us to inspire in our life journey. Third hindrance, growing secularism in ourself. Secular word itself means there is no God. As we are living in the world with secular people, our inspiration is world. And there are people around us who doesn't believe even God. There are atheistic people who doesn't have faith even in God. They say the world, there is no God. Now, when we are going through this pandemic situation, we all have that feeling that God is not there. He's not answering to our prayers. Even the Israel people had, the people who were selected by God had this question that God is not, doesn't exist. He doesn't hear to our prayer. If we have this thought, we are totally wrong. So rather than being secular, try ourselves to be more closer to God, to build up the spiritual inspiration through the Spirit, which will lead us to God from this world which is secular. So dearly beloved, we talked about the three factors that hinders Holy Spirit in us, which inspires us spiritually. Now I would like to help you out to get out of this hindrance which we face in spiritual inspiration, which help us to grow spiritually. Few exercises which you can do at home, it's very easy. You should not go out. I will not prefer you to go out, or we all know that we can't go to the church and pray even. But a few small spiritual exercises which will help you to change, which will help you to change your stand, which will help you to inspire the Holy Spirit in you to grow spiritually in your life. The first one is the Jesus prayer. You all know Jesus prayer. The most common Jesus prayer you all know. Lord Jesus, Son of God, have mercy upon us, a sinner. During these awaiting days, many celibate priests, monks in their monasteries, in their dairas and ashrams, sit awaiting for the Spirit by reciting this prayer. When we recite this prayer gives us two things. First one, the realization that we are a sinner. And Jesus has promised that he has come not for the righteous, but for the sinner. Secondly, he helps us to realize that we are giving priority to the world. So these two things will help us to understand that we are sinners. We need to be away from the world and be closer to God. So Jesus prayer will help us to inspire the Holy Spirit in us through that we can be spiritually inspired in our life journey. Second exercise which we can do in our houses, that is fasting and meditation. You all do yoga, you all do gym, you all do cycling, you all do swimming, etc. at your home. This is the smallest simple things which you can do, that is fasting and meditation. Due to constraint of time, I'm not getting into too much into that topic. Fasting and meditation, you all know. Meditation, which will help you to be more closer to God. And fasting, which will help you, your body, your conscience, your spiritual spirit to be strong. Fasting will help you to build up tolerance in your body as well as spirit to overcome the suffering in your journey. Meditation will inflame the Holy Spirit in you to inspire during suffering. So meditation and suffering will help you to inspire the Holy Spirit in you to be spiritually inspired. And the third thing, building up the faith by the Christ experience. Building up the faith by others Christ experience. As I talk about secularism, there is no God in this world. We do believe them, but there are some people among us, especially our parents, our relatives, our Sunday school teachers, our priests, our clergies, our bishops, who are the really true witnesses of the Christ experience. But we don't have time to go and talk to them. But God has prepared this time in this lockdown to sit at your home and ask your parents, ask your grandparents that how much Christ has interfered in their life to know, to be more closer to God rather than be away from that God. And there is no God concept should be clear when you sit at home. So this point can be clearly understand when we start having conversation with our parents, with our grandparents about their life journey, which they had, which was Christ experienced life journey. These things we can understand in Bible, where in the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 8, 26 to 40, chapter 8, 26 to 40, a story of a eunuch and Saint Philip, where the eunuch gets the real transformation into the ultimate truth. The eunuch doesn't know who is the real God in this world. So when you go back from this meeting, go and read this passage. Acts chapter 8, 26 to 40. This will help you to really understand the presence of God in this world. Because Saint Philip was the person who experienced Christ in his life and he shared it with that eunuch who was not knowing about God. So this will help you to grow spiritually and inspire yourself. So may I conclude? I have shared the word meaning of inspire, that is to create something good or to create something in you or inflame the Holy Spirit, the inflame, the fire of the Holy Spirit to grow spiritually in our life journey. I have told who all are inspired by the word of, by the Holy Spirit. I said living and the non-living together in this world, the whole creation is inspired by Holy Spirit. I've explained about the three factors, the most three important factors of the hindrance to the spiritual inspiration. Cause to inspiration was, the first one was priority to the world. When we give priority to the world, Holy Spirit in us can't come and work in us. Secondly, I said sufferings in the world. If sufferings overcome you, you will be in darkness. So you need to believe in Christ who has suffered for you and me. And he is the one who has overcome the sufferings. We believe in him, through that we can inspire ourselves, the Holy Spirit in us. Thirdly, I said the third factor which hinders ourselves from be away from Holy Spirit is growing secularism in our world. We are living in a society where people say God doesn't exist. But you need to understand by your parents, by your grandparents, looking to their life journey, asking them that they have really experienced Christ in their life. Along with that, I have shared the three simple spiritual exercises which will help you to inspire your Holy Spirit in you. Was the first one, the Jesus prayer. You can always recite, you should always recite, you should keep that prayer in your lips. Lord Jesus, Son of God, have mercy upon us, a sinner, which will enlighten your Holy Spirit, which will help you to be away from this world. Secondly, I mentioned about fasting and meditation. I'm not getting into deep because if we talk about fasting, it will take hours to talk. But fasting, we can all do. Being a youngster, we can all practice fasting and meditation at our home, which will help to build up the Holy Spirit in us. And thirdly, to experience the faith by the people who have experienced the Christ experience. As Saint Philip took the eunuch into the real ultimate truth, our parents, grandparents, Sunday school teachers, our clergies, our bishops, the church will help us to really understand the presence of God in our life. So thank you so much for the patient listening. I extend my thanks to Jacob Anishachan and all the office bearers to give me this wonderful chance to speak this evening. May God bless you all. Let the Holy Spirit inspire you in this world to live and deliver good fruits for this life journey which you are living in this world. Thank you so much. May God bless you all.
Thank you so much for that profound and thought-provoking talk. You took us on a wonderful journey through the Ark of Noah to the prophets, to the exile of Christ. Achin, your words were timely, and it's a reminder for us that the Spirit is to be inflamed.